Hey, yo, check out your boy Killer Cam, a.k.a. Flea Stern, and welcome to Road to the Rim 2, and shout out to Behind the Lens TV.
Everybody talking about, Flea, what you gonna do? And do what I want when I want. Okay. Welcome back. He wanted to play with me, man. I played with triggers. Took the oven off my waist, started baking niggas. Doctor brought him back to life. I'm like a braver niggas. Went in the ER, told him stop saving niggas.
Corey Homicide Williams. What is my knowledge about him? I put it to you this way. He's definitely in the top 20 players in street ball.
Corey Homicide Williams, you know, AK Homicide. I mean, you have to know him. You know, we grew up 3-4 blocks away from each other in the Bronx.
My name is Corey Homicide Williams, and I'm from the Bronx, New York. I had no good statistics leaving college. I didn't go to a big university. I didn't have a big reputation.
It was different for Homicide. He stayed under the radar. But I always knew he was working hard. You know, I always kept up with him and things like that because I knew what it took. You know, he was built from the same cloth as me coming from the Bronx.
If I had to characterize Homicide, I would put him as a blue-collar, hard-nosed worker that still makes 7 digits at his job every day if this was Wall Street.
He is relentless in his approach on the court. He's a bull. He's an animal. He's Homicide. He's 187. That's who he is.
This right here, don't mistake it for any bull. Pardon me, NBA TV. But just know that this is hard work out here. I had to score 26 points on Ron Artest to get it. You might not believe it. The tape ain't on NBA TV to show it. But I'm telling you, that's how I got MVP. Ask. It's not a game out here. Trust me, I work hard.
So all I had was the playgrounds in New York City to try and make a career.
Jesse Sack, Mr. Hoyer, Paul Workman. This guy right here is, he's New York too. New York has, especially Harlem, has always been known for the flair. The flair for the dramatic, the entertainment part of that. That entertainment is part of what Sapp brings to the table.
With Sapp, he had to make his way. He had to fight for his recognition. He's been underrated in, you know, for years. Because people were like, oh, that's the kid from the East, he making a little noise, But then once he went to Georgetown, and people really started respecting his shit, you know? He started playing in the Kingdoms, and I made sure he was playing in these tournaments.
Yeah, when it comes to True Asia, I've never seen nobody support anybody like that. I mean, of course, our brother, but, you know, she's worse than Steph Curry's mother. If you look at Road to the Rim 1, it's a part on Road to the Rim 1 where Sapp does a move and her other sister run right to this part of the court and do a chest bump.
Myself and my girlfriend, which is one of Sapp's good friends, Moe, shout out to Moe. For us, that wasn't a plan. That just goes to show that we was all on one accord. It was like everything was in sync. Like, we all was thinking on the same level, like, eat this nigga up. And when he did it and shot the three and hit it, it was automatic. We ran and just chest bump. Everybody know the chest bump when anybody, everybody watch all types of sports, especially basketball. When a nigga chest bump another nigga, it's like, yeah, like, we killed this nigga. And that's what that was. That was me. You seen myself and Moe, we jump up and hit each other in the chest. That was just Sapp's emotions in human form.
First rule to the rim. It was myself versus a guy named Adrian Walton, a.k.a. Butter, a.k.a. Whole Lot of Game. And the buildup for that game was crazy. It was the east side of Harlem just had my back. The west side of Harlem had his back. And it was special, man. It was special. I think him talking the way he was talking and me talking the way I was talking, it was just like, everybody wanted to see the game. It was a game that had to be played. The game was harder than I expected. Let me take that back. The game wasn't as hard as I expected it to be. The game wasn't as hard as I expected it to be. I wanted it to be a slug match. I wanted it to be a back and forth. It was exciting. But it was a one-way excitement, you know what I mean? But I feel like I didn't go into the game worrying about what he was gonna do. I went into the game just focused on what I was doing.
Many African kings have gotten their head cut off and died in battle, but they went out the right way, respectable way. To go out the way he went out for his last game, I don't even know what that life is about.
So now we're here for Road to the Rim 2. Jesse Sapp versus Corey Williams. Homicide versus Sapp. It's gonna be a goodie, man. Harlem versus the Bronx.
Well, you know, I just want to put on a good event for Harlem. Of course, the Bronx, they're gonna be here. Baltimore's gonna be here because Akil Carr's playing. You know, I got the girl Young M.A., she's performing in between games. I want to put on a good event for Harlem, you know what I'm saying? Even though we're in the Bronx and everything else, you know, we don't get a lot of this anymore. Of course, it's the tournaments. Of course, it's the Rutgers, the Dykemans, the Kingdoms, et cetera, et cetera. But this brings it back to the essence of what I grew up in.
I mean, one of my friends, you could tell me that Corey was the guy. Corey was the guy. I spoke to him the other day, and I said, yo, I got your guy. And he started laughing. He's incarcerated right now, but I'm like, yo, I got your guy. So I'm like, yo, it's gonna happen.
You know, this is a gladiator kind of sport, what we're doing right now, this one-on-one. This is gladiator basketball. Only the strong is gonna survive. And sometimes the strongest may not be the one who won.
The Bronx coming out to see Corey play. You won't see a lot of this in the crowd. A lot of them BX boys gonna be throwing this up on Sunday, man. They rep they barrel, man. So Homicide definitely got the Bronx on his back, and he gotta show up.
And I know what it is. Bronx versus Harlem. Homicide, you know what it is. You know, we're not gonna talk about it. See you Sunday.
Street ball need this. We don't have this no more. Back in the days, we was able to go to the King Domes and the Rutgers and, you know, just and just see this type of good basketball being played.
I'm going all the fuck out. My motto has always been win, lose, or draw, you gonna know my fucking name at the end of the game. I've lost more than I've won. I've just won at the right time.
It's a saying, reputations take years to build, but only seconds to lose. So it depends on how the loss goes. A blowout for Homicide, meaning Homicide losing the blowout, everybody's automatically gonna throw him under the bus because he's older. He's old, he's washed up, he's finished. It's a wrap for him, he need to move on and coach and do something. Like, that's how the streets are gonna take it.
Reputations take years to build and seconds to lose. And I don't intend on losing.
In the beginning, I was frustrated when I heard that Homicide wanted to play Sapp. Like, why now everybody want to play you, nigga? Like, now everybody want to give you time. Now everybody want to be on your shit. You know what I mean? But then when you sit back and you step out the box and you look at the picture, and you step out the picture and you look at it, it's a good look because the Bronx, that's who they repping. He the best, right? A Butter was supposed to be the best one-on-one for Harlem. Sapp beat him. So why wouldn't the best from the Bronx want to play Sapp? I'd have been insulted if he didn't step up to the plate and act. So at the end of the day, I felt it was a good look. I'd have been very insulted if he didn't ask for that challenge. Because that means he didn't respect Sapp on that level. You get what I'm trying to say? Like, I tell everybody, they like, why Sapp got to play him? Why nobody else? I said, because there's nobody else worthy of Sapp playing him. So, pull up.
The one thing I will say about Sapp, he doesn't do a lot of talking, so it's hard to read him. But he had a real chip on his shoulder last game because he wanted to be A Butter bad.
Everybody wanted to see who was better between us. This one is like, this is a personal match that I feel like it's for me, and I think it's going to be a good one.
The question is that same chip on his shoulder for Homicide? Is he comfortable? Does he think this is in the bag already because he's the Road to the Rim champion? That's the question.